Detroit police arrested a man Thursday night they're calling a serial rapist.
Investigators say the man abducted two women within 24 hours and assaulted them before he was finally arrested. Fox News' Roop Raj is live on Detroit's west side.
Yeah, he did it in a brazen way, Q. He basically stopped his car, picked them up, and did the terrible crimes that he did. Those victims spoke up right away. They gave very explicit details, and credit's being given to them for this guy being caught.
He's had multiple addresses in the city. He's moved around quite a bit. Took us a few minutes to identify him, but we were able to, obviously, with the help of the victims, be able to do so quickly.
Detroit police think they have their man. We're talking about a 30-year-old who would pull up in his car, get out, show the victims his gun, and take them away. Two rapes starting on Wednesday. The violent serial rapist finally stopped here at this gas station at Puritan. Police say credit goes to the Sex Crimes Division of Detroit Police, but it especially goes to the two women who were raped.
The strength and the actions of these two victims, they had to keep telling their story over and over again so that we could try and glean whatever information we could to help us identify this individual. So they are the real heroes here.
Surveillance of the man nonstop, night and day. It paid off. Wednesday, he raped one woman, then moved on and raped a second woman right afterwards. Sergeant Woody describing the act as something done by a monster.
It was the victims stood in defiance and said, you know what, we're not going to be victims here. We're not going to be just stand by and be damaged by this and let this monster do what he did to another woman. We're not going to let that happen.
Chief Craig, along with the Special Victims Unit at Detroit Police, think there may be other victims who didn't come forward out of fear. They're hoping they'll step forward too, setting an example for other women involved in cases like this.
When you talk about a sexual assault suspect, especially a suspect who certainly shows any indication of being a serial rapist, in such a short amount of time, certainly becomes a public safety issue.
Yeah, public safety issue. They're giving credit to the Special Victims Unit, the Sex Crimes Unit behind us at Detroit Police Headquarters. They also, though, are giving most of the credit to those victims. They say often is the case where these victims don't step up out of fear, shame, embarrassment, whatever it is. There is no reason to be any of those things. If you think you're a victim of one of these crimes, you're asked to pick up the phone and call police right away. You'll see how quickly they can work to catch the person responsible. Reporting live in Detroit, Roop Raj, Fox 2 News.
And Roop, when do we expect to see a photo of this suspect? Because I know that officers were asking earlier, they want people who may have been a victim of this person to step forward. So when will we see who he is and what he looks like?
Yeah, once he's formally charged, we can identify who this person is. As of now, though, this is a person who obviously they believe is the suspect. This is a person who they watched very carefully. They looked at the descriptions of the cars. They then went further into looking into the neighborhood that he was staying in. They said he hopped from house to house. They watched him carefully and then made their move to go in. The lesson here, Q, is for other victims, perhaps unrelated to this altogether. The lesson Detroit police want to give all the women out there, or anybody who's watching right now, is if you speak up soon, if you speak up quickly, the person who's responsible can be picked up just as fast.
All right, Roop Raj reporting live from Detroit. Thank you, Roop.